Hinges creak in doorless chambers, and strange and frightening sounds echo through the halls whenever candlelights flicker where the air is deathly still. That is the time when ghosts are present, practicing their terror with ghoulish delight. Welcome, foolish mortals, to the Haunted Mansion. I am your host, your ghost host. Kindly step all the way in, please, and make room for everyone. There's no turning back now. Our tour begins here in this gallery, where you see paintings of some of our guests as they appeared in their corruptible, mortal state. Your cadaverous pallor betrays an aura of foreboding, almost as though you sense a disquieting metamorphosis. Is this haunted room actually stretching, or is it your imagination? And consider this dismaying observation. This chamber has no windows and no doors, which offers you this chilling challenge to find a way out. Of course, there's always my way.
Hi everyone, it's Max Power, and I've got a new collectible here that I want to share with you guys. This is the wall-mounted Hatbox Ghost. Only five were made. This I got from a gentleman. His name is Chuck Jarman. He has a store on Etsy, so if anyone wants to take a look at what he has in his store, he only made five of these, and they're all sold out. I was lucky enough to get the last one. This is number five. I actually saw this item on Greg's YouTube channel called Palco Designs. So I have him as one of my people that I take a look at. So I subscribe to his channel. So if you see who I subscribe to, you'll see his channel. He has a lot of neat stuff. Anyways. So I saw it on his channel and I knew I had to figure out a way to get it. So he was nice enough to let me know where he got it from, and I found Chuck Jarman's Etsy shop. It's called Little Shop of Horrors. So again, take a look at his store. He's got a lot of neat stuff there. So anyway, love this piece. It's got the glow effect, as you can see. It looked fantastic when I turned off the light. So definitely a piece that I will have. When I thought I was going to put it somewhere, and the wall plaque is a little too big, so I have to find a different place to put him. But wherever he's going to go is going to be the highlight of the room. So let me go ahead and get a little close here so everyone can take a look at this Hatbox Ghost. And if you don't know what the Hatbox Ghost, and the music didn't give it away, if you ever gone to Disneyland or Disney World, the Haunted Mansion, this is one of the ghosts there. There's a whole thing going on about this particular item that I found out. So if anyone's interested in that, they can just do a search on YouTube for the Hatbox Ghost. And there's also this big story about when he made it onto the theme park and all this other stuff. So really neat stuff there too. Anyway, so the sculpt on this is really just fantastic. The eyes, pretty creepy. So Chuck really did an excellent job with how he sculpted this. It's all resin right here, and this is what holds it right here. And behind it, believe it or not, it does actually have a little voice box there where the theme of the Disneyland or the Haunted Mansion song plays. So whatever you heard on the stereo there, that's what you hear when you press this button right here. I'll turn it on here in a couple of minutes. I just wanted to show the entire thing first. The hat is sculpted, so it doesn't it's a separate sculpt, but it's doesn't detach, so it's glued on there. Everything else has been sculpted on. The wood is the kind of is really a nice touch, although mine came a little bit scratched here, but no big deal. It's going to be hanging, so I don't think anyone's ever going to see that part of it. And if it bothers me enough, I'll paint it myself. This is synthetic here, so it's really nice. Real nice touch on the plaque here. All right, I'm going to go ahead and turn on the music so you guys can hear what the what it sounds like. So it's really loud for that, for being such a little thing. And this right here, it's actually Velcroed on, so I can remove this and put batteries here. So, you know, at any time, or just take it off altogether. It doesn't matter. You know, if you just want it to just be hanging on the wall and not have to worry about the music. So this isn't too long. So, but it's really neat that Chuck did that. So let me turn it on. So that's pretty neat. It goes on for a little bit longer with the song. You can turn it off just by the clicking it again, or just let it run until it stops. So real neat that's on there, especially if you use it, you know, hanging on the wall, and you have the little clicker. You can turn it on whenever you want. But the one thing that I enjoy of this collectible is definitely the glow effect. So I'm going to show you how bright this thing is. It is, whatever he used to paint this, it is fantastic. I've never seen such a bright glow effect on anything, really, as bright as this is. I've got the LED lights right here run on it, so it when I turn off the lights, you guys are really going to see how bright it is. And in addition to that, I'm going to show you what it looks like with a black light. So I got a black light that I'm going to use, because with the LEDs, it hits it and then it kind of starts to dim real quick. So in order for me to kind of let you guys see what I see, the black light gives it the best effect. And in addition to, once the black light is on, it seems to absorb the light even more, so it brightens up even more. So it's just really a fantastic item and a fantastic glow effect that it gives off. So let me go ahead and turn off the lights here, you guys. All right, turning off lights here and here. All right, so there, as you can see, now in camera, it starts to dim a little bit faster, but trust me, guys, in hand, this thing just, it looks creepy. It looks like it's, brightens up the entire room when it is fully charged. So I've had the lights on there. Again, it's starting to dim down, but in front of me, I can see the details. I can see everything. And that's why I'm going to, sorry, I hit the camera there. That's why I'm going to go ahead and turn on the black light, so you really get the full effect on how awesome this thing is. All right, so there we go. I've turned on the black light. As you can see, it's starting to absorb the light, so it's really starting to pick up that brightness there. Just amazing. If you guys could only see this in hand, you would be totally amazed how cool this wall mount Hatbox is. I'm going to go ahead and turn off the black light so you guys can see. It's absorbed some of the light. And there. Absolutely. It's just nuts. I love it. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and put the black light over the camera here. So at its brightest, what you're seeing here, it's actually how bright it looks in the room. I am not kidding. This thing is super bright. And if I could just have a black light on it all the time, I would. But this is actually what you see when it's fully charged and it's got light, it's had light on it, and you turn off the lights and it just looks amazing. Okay, I'm turning off the lights now. Look at that. You can see the detail. It's just, I love it. And the camera is really picking up really, really bright, so you guys are actually seeing what I'm seeing. All right, I'm going to turn on the light again. What I'm going to do is I'm going to move the camera. Excuse me. I'm going to move the camera further out so you guys can get really even a better idea how bright this mount is, or the Hatbox is. All right, there we are. So as you can see, you're able to see the black light on there. I'm going to go ahead and turn that off. All right, so there you go, guys. Isn't that amazing? Let me get that camera there. All right. In hand, it's amazing how bright it looks. I'm turning on the black light again. A little closer. I think my camera's going out of focus. Okay, here we are. Have to get back in focus. Okay. All right, and that's from a pretty good distance away. That's exactly what you see in the darkness. That's what you see. I'm going to go ahead and turn off the light again. Pitch dark in here, guys, and look how amazing it looks. Okay, I'm going to do it again. This time I'm going to get just a little bit closer so the black light really shines on it some more and charges the paint up a little bit more. All right, there we go. I want to make sure the camera is in focus. It's really getting a nice charge right now, so I'm going to turn off the lights. Look at that. And get really close here. Again. Light, let it charge up. There we go, that's really a nice view there, right there. Trying to get the best angle so you guys can see. All right. Turning off the lights. All right, one more shot here, you guys. So I'm going to go even further away. I'm going to see if I can really, sometimes it's going to be a little bit difficult because of the focus, but hopefully I'm pretty good of a distance away here. So, and I've got the black light charging it right now. I'm going to get back there. Turning it off. And just make a sweep right there so really gets the light on there. All right, turning it off. Like that in the pitch dark. I'm gonna get closer. So again, this thing is amazing. if there was any type of nitpicking that I would do, is that I would have really would have liked that they had you could remove it, so you can either do it without the hat or maybe tilt the hat a little more. That would have been kind of a nice option to have had. But no big deal. Obviously, if it's going to be up on the wall, you won't be adjusting the hat or anything. So, and probably Chuck did that by design, so it doesn't fall off his head wherever it is. The other nitpick, minor, of course, because that's just more of a preference for me, is I really would have liked the PVC piping that holds the head to maybe have been either a different material, possibly, I don't know, maybe covered with a resin, with part of the resin, so it looks like maybe his neck rather than just the PVC piping. That really would have added to this, and it would have looked like he was coming out of the headboard there. So that really would have made that extra touch, but again, I am very, very happy with this. Chuck did an amazing job with the sculpt on this. If you like neat stuff, horror stuff, check out his Etsy store. He's got a lot of neat stuff there. And, you know, Greg Palco Design, thank you so much for letting me know about this piece. All right, guys, I'm going to go ahead and end the video. Hopefully you enjoyed it. I will see you soon. I have other pieces coming, so stay tuned. All right, we'll see ya.